Brothers and sisters, I wanted to come on here and say hallelujah. This is your brother from another mother here in the mediocre state of North Carolina. Praise God. I restarted this video, brothers and sisters, because, you know, we need to be rejoicing, praising God without ceasing. We are leaning on the everlasting arms of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Bless His holy name. I came on here to give you a praise report, brothers and sisters. I just got an email from a brother, Ken, who is the director of the executive director of Jack Van Impe's Ministries International. And he let me know that Dr. Jack and Rex Sullivan Impe saw the video that I made, and you guys praying in agreement with me. And Dr. Jack has been moved by the blessing of God. By the grace of God, Dr. Jack Van Impe, who's in his 80s, has been moved to rehab from, you know, the critical condition that he was in and complications from had a triple bypass heart surgery. As I said, he's in his 80s. He had complications from that. And now, by the grace of God and God's love and blessing to the body of Christ, because it says he gave some apostles, some prophets, some pastors, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, Ephesians 4:11, you know, till we all come together, you know, into that perfect body of Christ. And brother, our brother from another mother, Dr. Jack Van Impe, is definitely, as I said in the last video, he is a gift from God, because God gave some apostles, some prophets, and Dr. Jack Van Impe is a teacher and an evangelist. God gave him to the body of Christ. Praise God for his good gifts, and one of the best gifts that the Lord gave the church in this final generation is our blessed brother from another mother, Dr. Jack Van Impe, and his wife, our blessed sister, Rexella Van Impe. Praise God for them, and thank the Lord, brothers and sisters, that God has despaired and extended the life of our dear brother, Dr. Jack Van Impe, and I ask you to continue to pray for him. He asked that we would continue to pray for him. He said he thanked us for our prayers. It was heartfelt to him and Rexella that we've been praying for them. And it's such a blessing to, you know, to see that dear brother and sister in Christ after all of these years. I just want to say that on here too. You know, we talk about the book, The Late Great Planet Earth from 1970 by Brother Hal Lindsey. Dr. Jack Van Impe's been preaching the end times message since, I think there was a recording one time on his show. He had this record of him teaching about the end times. Same stuff he's teaching today, brothers and sisters. And I believe it was 1948 or 1949, somewhere around in there. Maybe 1950, way back. Dr. Jack Van Impe was leading the charge and pronouncing, you know, I guess after he saw Israel be reborn in 1948. You know, since that time, he's been teaching, you know, we are coming into the, you know, this is it. We are that generation that would not taste death, but see the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Bless his holy name. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to continue to pray for Dr. Jack Van Impe and his wife, Sister Rexella. And brothers and sisters, I ask you to keep looking up, because you know what the Word of God says? I want to add this on here. I want to add this on here, and this is really in reference to my brother from another mother, who's a father in the faith to me. I'm joking about the, you know, even calling him a brother, because he is a father in the faith. The Bible says, Paul says, we have many, you know, people, but only a few fathers in the Lord. And Dr. Jack Van Impe is a father in the Lord to millions of people. And I want to say this about honor of Dr. Jack Van Impe. There's a sister, and she knows who she is. I just saw her recently, Sister Mary. And, you know, she is a sister who is always, always looking for the rapture. I mean, every time I talk to her, you know, she is all fired up every day about the rapture. And just today, brothers and sisters, this afternoon, I was out, you know, doing a prayer walk, and I was just saying to the Lord, you know, I love Sister Mary, but every time I talk to her, that's all she talks is about the rapture. And you know what the Lord said to me? This is for Sister Mary and our dear brother, Dr. Jack Van Impe. The Lord said, you know, into my spirit, the Lord spoke into my spirit and said that, you know, she, just like, you know, Mary and Martha, she, Sister Mary has chosen the good thing, because the Bible says, and the Lord brought this Bible verses to my attention, that it says that there's a crown, Paul said there's a crown of righteousness stored up for those who love his appearing. For those who love his appearing. And I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, that's the thing about Dr. Jack Van Impe, you know, that is so pleasing to our Lord and Savior. He loves the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. And Sister Mary, who I just saw recently, again, and we talked about the rapture, Sister Mary loves his appearing. And the Lord said, you know, just like Mary and Martha in the Bible, you know, she has chosen the good thing, the good thing. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. The Lord is well pleased with his children who are looking and longing for and groaning. As Paul said in Romans chapter 8, the whole creation is in travail for the sons of God to be revealed. That is the resurrection of the saints, brothers and sisters. That resurrection, a.k.a. we call it from the Latin word rapture, to be snatched up, to be caught up, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up with them. That's the raptura word there in Latin. We use that doctrinal name, rapture, to be caught up, snatched up, harpoza in the Greek, harpozo, to be caught up, to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we forever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Brothers and sisters, praise the living God. And I praise the Lord specifically. I ask you to come and agree with me. Let's praise the Lord and ask the Lord and believe that our dear brother, Dr. Jack Van Impe, would never taste death, and that his love for the rapture would be rewarded to him to see the rapture. Brothers and sisters, we are so close. Everything's coming together. As you guys know, the signs are all here. Everything's lined up for the second coming of Christ at the end of the tribulation. Everything's lined up for the start of the tribulation. And before the tribulation, brothers and sisters, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, we shall not sleep, but we will be transformed. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51 and 52. We will be transformed. We will take off this corruptible earthen vessel, brothers and sisters, and put on the incorruption, a glorified, resurrected body, just like our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ had after the resurrection. Praise his holy name. Brothers and sisters, bless the name of the Lord. And I ask you to thank the Lord that he has given the gift of Dr. Jack Van Impe to the body of Christ, and to continue to do the mighty work he's done for God. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. Bless his holy name. Praise God, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Bless his holy name, brothers and sisters. I'm just praising the Lord today, for God is good. All the time, God is good. Bless his holy name. God bless you all.